Sam from Liberty. Welcome back to my tea channel. Today I'd like to talk about how to hold your teapot like a professional. Of course, we're going to talk about different techniques to pick up different teapots according to the design of the handle. You can see that I have mainly three styles. There are more, but these three are the main ones, and also what I can pull out of my tea cupboard. Secondly, I would like to talk a little bit about the history of these different shapes. Maybe its origin, but it's really brief because, as you know, each teapot, you can write a book about that. This is just a fun video about how to pick up the teapot and looking confident and knowledgeable. But really, I believe that there is no correct way of doing this, because all you need to achieve is one, not to burn yourself. So for example, this teapot is made of silver, so if you touch the surface, obviously it's going to be really hot, or if you spill water on your hand, we don't want to see that happen. Another dangerous place is that you need to look out of where they will punch a hole to let the steam come out, so you also want to avoid that as well. So place your hand where you won't be burned by the steam, the liquid, or the pot itself. Also, if you can withdraw the water in a timely manner, and then you will already achieve the purpose of brewing a good pot of tea. So without further ado, let's start. Now, with the camera bringing closer to us, this is the first teapot that I would like to demonstrate. As you can see, the handle is on the side of the teapot, so the most common type that we will encounter. By the way, this is called a shui ping hu, a very classic design in Yixing teapot. It is a relatively small one. It fits nicely into my hand. And we have a bigger one here. Even with the same shape, you might hold it differently. Shui ping hu is a very classic teapot recommend for brewing oolong tea. I think in the 80s, this is the main teapot style that's been exported to from Yixing to Taiwan, and very very common shape in Chaozhou Gongfu Cha as well. And a good Yixing teapot, by the way, should be very light in weight. And also the handle, the I don't know what this is called in English, but I will look it up. I don't know what it's called, but and the spell handle, the lid, and the spell should be in one line. And then the reason why it's called shui ping hu is also that when you pop this teapot in the water, it should just float by itself, and it is very level and balanced and would not sink. That is one of the tests that you can do with your shui ping hu and see if it's up to standard. So, as you can see, out of habit, I already picked up the way I meant to demonstrate. If you haven't played with one of these teapot before, you are very likely to hook your index finger over the handle, and then when you want to steady the lid, you will do this. But the tea masters tend to handle the teapot with one hand rather than two. So loop your middle fingers
over, you pinch it with your thumb. So you got, you know, full control of the pot now. And then for the ladies, you can press your index finger onto the lid. With the bigger teapot, let me go over the technique again. So you loop the middle finger over, you steady the handle with your thumb, and then you try to use your index to steady. But as you can see that this is a bigger shaping hole, it's not as comfortable for me to hold as this one. So that's why sometimes you can just place index finger onto the lid itself, and I like to use my fingernail, so I don't need to touch it with my skin. With the gentlemen's, you can use your middle fingers and your index finger to steady the teapot, and then press with your thumb, such as this. Now this is teapot number 2. This is in Chinese called a 茶壶, so a side handle teapot. You can see that the teapot and the spout is a 90 degree angle, unlike the 180 one that we showed before with this shaping. In Japan, this is called a kyushu, because I first encountered this style of the teapot from making Japanese shincha, sencha, and hojicha. As you can see that this is a Japanese made one as well. Chinese do not tend to use the metal mesh inside of the pot. This is to prevent the lid from coming out of the side, into the tea liquid. I made the comment to my Chinese tea peer that Kyushu was invented in Japan. How little I know. He said that, side handle teapot was also first invented in China, or first designed in China. This is a beautiful tea story where, something was made in one place, and then it was taken to another place, across the sea, and it got developed there. And then later on, the style of the teapot will be influencing the country that originally started making it. And then this back and forth is what I love. And then it also make the design and tea drinking more interesting, and the cultural background more complex as well. The reason why Japanese prefer a side handle teapot is that they think that the movement of holding a kyushu is a little bit more elegant with a shaping hole. It's not as smooth. You sort of need to tilt your waist in more of an angle, so it doesn't look as natural. But with kyushu, it's a very simple movement where you just turn your arm rather than twisting your whole hand. This is the first way that you can hold a kyushu. You use your four fingers to hold onto the side handle, and then use your thumb to steady the lid. It's a more of a masculine way to do it. The second way is that you still hold, but you hold with your thumb and the three fingers, and then use your index to hold onto the lid, such as this. Of course, you can always go back to these. There's nothing wrong with that, especially if you're handling a very heavy teapot. But there is still a little trick that makes it look more professional, is that you actually make your hand flat and then press against it like this. Then it will look more professional. Now this is pot number three. This handle, it is on the top. In Chinese, it's called 提梁壶. 提 means lift, and then 梁 means bridge. So it's like a little bridge on top of the teapot where you can lift it. This is one thing I love about Chinese language, is that everything is very descriptive. You're pretty much just trying to describe what it is, and you'll be able to remember the vocabularies. We have two 提梁壶 here. I'll try to think of an English translation, but if you have a good one, please leave a comment below. So the smaller bridge lifting pot is actually made by an Australian potter, the talented Mina. All of her stuff are full handmade and with a very, very distinct personal characteristic, as she likes to use a multi-faucet finish. All the finish of her wares, quite rough, very close to what we would have seen before, the very precise tools and machineries were made to, make teawares. But because of that, it makes me love this teapot even more. But one thing that I will mention is that when you are picking your teapot, the height of the spout, if it's higher than, the lid. But ideally, if you're buying a Yixing teapot, for example, you do not want to see this happening. It will be a big mistake, if you're learning from a Yixing master and you make a pot, raised like this. Visually, it looks a little bit, unusual with the raised spout, and it looks beautiful this way. But in practical turn, ideally your spout should be level with the lid. Just want to quickly show you all the other pot. As you can see, it's pretty much level, so the water wouldn't come out of here when you're trying to get the water out. Same as the Japanese teapot. Even though it's tiny bit raised, it wouldn't be too significant, the difference. And same as the shaping hole. So I have seen people, and I may have done it myself, is that they will intuitively hold it up with their four fingers, and then with the thumb pressing from the top and trying to, pull the water, such as this. So you use your two fingers, your thumb and your index, and try to pinch it. As you can see, you lift it up, pretty effortlessly. And then when you're trying to, pull the tea or the water out, you can quickly turn to do it again. You turn, as you can see, now you have your thumb hooked, as you can see there, and then with your two fingers pointing at where you would like to pull. And this way, you have more of a control tilt the teapot. And then when you finish it and you would like to put it back, you can quickly turn your hand and then pop it back down. So with a bigger teapot, you might want to use all three fingers rather than just the two. You will pinch it, such as these. And then when you're ready to pull, you turn and, you know, use your index finger to point at the direction where you want the water to go. When you finish, you quickly turn your finger back and then pop it back down like that.
That will be everything that I'd like to share with you tonight. I hope you had enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel and share and to comment underneath and tell me what you think. And because your comments and feedback is a big motivation of, you know, me continuing to do this. Thank you and see you next time.